What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Lyrical Resonance, where we believe that where words fail, music speaks. We are getting into a song here by Crowder. We have not done anything by him before. It's definitely going to be a CMM, Christian Contemporary, or CCM, excuse me, Christian Contemporary song. Really excited to get into it. This is Crowder's song, Back to the Garden. Now, I'm a big fan of Crowder. I think he makes music in such a way that, I mean, the dude hears stuff and is able to create these sounds that just, they blend genre as well. I mean, he does a really good blend of kind of like hip-hop and country, which sounds crazy, but he does it very well. Now, if this is your first time with us, thank you so much for watching, number one. But if you like what you see at the end of this, make sure you hit that like button, hit subscribe, and turn on the notification bell to stay up to date with all the videos. Because where words fail, music does speak, and we're going to be here always listening to what the music has to say. So let's get into this song. This is Back to the Garden by Crowder. Do you hear what I mean? He just, the way he makes his music, he's pulling out all kinds of different sounds. And this is such a hauntingly beautiful opening to this song. Just that piano, the ambience that's going on kind of behind it, and then his voice always impresses me, man. This is, I don't know how often I'll be stopping, so I have a feeling I'm going to get lost in this. Let's keep going.
I was born from the soil. I got dirt inside of me. But I was born to be royal. I was
hard-hitting song. Fairly simple chorus, but those words, man. You're looking at this from obviously a Christian perspective, thinking about what life would have been like in the garden, how Adam and Eve were able to walk with God. I mean, physically walk with him, you know, like friends walking in a park. And just thinking about being able to get back to that, dude, I can't imagine anything greater. And so it's like when we start looking at hope and, you know, what lies beyond, it's real easy to get caught up in the idea of heaven and, you know, the sitting on a cloud and all that stuff, but that's not at all what the goal is. The goal is I say goal as if it's something we have to work to achieve, but God's already accomplished it. It's like his version of calling 8-ball corner pocket. He spoke about a future event like it was an absolute certainty, because for him it is. And so he's, what the ultimate is perfection. For the created, for the creation to operate as it was intended. And so when we talk about heaven, what we really should be talking about as kind of our destination, what we should really be talking about is creation restored to how it was originally intended. That's when we talk about a new heaven and a new earth. That's what we're talking about, is where God will, in the second coming of Christ, will do away with the old and bring about the new, and things will operate as they were supposed to, which is why there's no more tears, no more pain, no more suffering. And having this idea of being able to walk with God, take me back to the garden and walk with me. What a heartfelt, earnest cry that just... Yeah, I would echo that sentimentality. Take me back to the garden. Walk with me. Dude, this is so good. That guitar is so crazy and so fitting, and it really, I mean, this whole song has such a tenseness to it where it feels like there should be a release of that tension, but that guitar, I don't feel like releases it. I feel like if anything, it intensifies the tension. It increases and cranks it up to another level. And just says, you think it's tense, wait till you feel this. And oof, man, that was superb.
Born to be royal, I was made to be free.
Okay, so there we have Back to the Garden by Crowder. What a song. Good grief. Where to even start with this? Because I feel like the music was borderline perfect. I mean, this was just... Talk about a song that just... It doesn't pull or like tug on your heartstrings. No, it rips at your heartstrings, man. from that first opening line. I was born to be royal. I was made to be free. But I was torn from the garden when that devil lied to me. And you can even take this away from the concept of, like, the original sin, which was Adam and Eve sinning in the garden. You could take this away from that and you could apply it to your own life, because we all screw up. Nobody's perfect. We all make mistakes. And a lot of the times, the things we do follow the same pattern of it looks good. It seems like it should be good. We want the power that we might associate with it. And so we do something stupid that gets us in trouble. And I really, really enjoyed how Crowder presented this, because he's saying, I was meant to be in the garden, man. Like, that's what I was created for, was to walk with God. I was created to hang out with him, to have a friendship with him. And because of sin, because of that entering into the world, that relationship is broken. And I might still be able to connect with him and relate with him and have a relationship with him through his son, Jesus. But it's going to always be kind of distanced a little bit, because I can't walk with him in the garden. You know what I mean? Like, I can't walk hand in hand with him. I can't hang out with him. I can pray and I can talk and I can read the Bible and try to find him there and hear from him through that. But I can't walk with him. Not yet. Anyway, not till he's back, not till he's set things in their proper order. And so, man, this was such a powerful song, and I really, really enjoyed I hesitate to say simplicity of the song, because, I mean, as it progressed, there was more and more added to it that was just so stinking crazy. But it really was a relatively simplistic song, and in a good way, that it built upon itself, and there's a tension to it that never really finds the proper release. Even by the end of the song, it ends with kind of this lament of, I was born to be royal, I was born to be free. And it kind of leaves this question, this question mark behind it, because that's what I was made to be. I was born to be royal, to be free. And if we look at the human experience, we're still not. Like, we still do stupid stuff, and until we enter into that relationship with God, we're very unlikely to find that kind of freedom. We're very unlikely to find that kind of rest, and it's not going to be until Christ comes back that we enter into our proper standing with God. And so it's, man, this is, what a song, and it's just so good, so good. I'm giving this a 10 out of 10 because it's just that good. I think I've done like 3 10s in a row now. I can't even remember, but this was so, so excellently done, and just what a song, man. What a song. Anyway, let me know what you thought about this song. What did you think? How would you enjoy it? If you were to rank it on a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being terrible, 10 being amazing, where do you put it? Because I put it at a 10 and it's fantastic, and I want to know what you think. If there are any songs you want me to check out, leave a comment, send me an email at lyrical.resonance.ia@gmail.com, or find me on Facebook. I'm there. Just search for Lyrical Resonance. You should be able to find me. You can find the logo on the YouTube channel on my Facebook page as well. Yeah, this is good. I also have a playlist on Apple Music for all the songs that I have reacted to, as well as upcoming songs, so you can kind of see what I'm getting into and what I'll be reacting to. But anyway, that's going to do it for us here on this video. Thank you again so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you haven't already, make sure to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss any of the videos, because where words fail, music does speak, and we're going to continue listening to what it has to say. But until our next one, as always, stay safe and be blessed. We'll see you soon.